All right, Shalom. First and foremost, I want to give all praises to Yahweh Ba'ashim Yahushai Ba'ashim Rakakudash. You know, Yahweh being the Heavenly Father's name. Ba'ashim means through the name. Yahushai being the one who the world ignorantly calls Jesus Christ. And Rakakudash meaning spirit holy. Double honors to the apostles and elders of Great Millstone who rule well and teach well. Peace and blessings to the elect Achim out there and the one third that's pushing this word in truth and sincerity in whatever way they can. This is going to be another confusion of face, strangers, Gentile, all right, video. Because, you know, I was meditating upon this song, you know. This song came out back in 2013. And, you know, it was bumping. You know, every time it came on, everybody would do the little dance. I was like, yo, this dude's a Jake, all right? Because, you know, only Israelites, are trendsetters, you know, especially with trends that go global, all right? And this is, you know, one of those examples, all right? He's from South Korea, you know, he's among the Ammonites, but yet, you know, you got Israel scattered throughout the whole world, all right? This is a prime example of it. I'm gonna play the music video, all right?
Open Gangnam Style! Gangnam Style!
Hey man, look at the little Jake go. Man, that kid is definitely a Jake, man. Only Israel moves like that. Alright. They even got Jake selling out across the world, man. Here it is. They got him, you know, wrapped up in a towel like a bitch, you know, in a sauna, leaning on another dude. And my brother actually studied abroad in South Korea, and he told me, like, yeah, man, that like they're okay with like homosexuality, you know, they're cool with it. You know, the older generation isn't, but like the newer generation, like today, you know, like the older generation isn't really, you know, hype about it, but the newer generation is like okay with it. All right, they definitely drunk that Babylon juice. Yeah, man, that little gallop, man. Every time the song came on back in 2013, everybody would start doing that little gallop dance, you know. And it's only Jake that comes up with these like simple dance moves, and it goes worldwide, you know. Like modern day example, that Block Boy JB dance, that shoot, the whip, the nene. You know, they're simple dances. And what's funny about that is the heathens can't do those simple dances, you know? Even the simple ones like the whip, heathens can't do that, all right? So, I mean, this dude's definitely a Jake. And you see he has the chicks in the background with him, you know? And another thing is my brother told me, you know, when he was in South Korea, they loved the American culture, but they hated Jake, man. Like he said, they're like low key prejudice against black people, but yet they put white people over their own, like it was cool to be white, you know, like they even like They uplifted white people more than Korean people, you know? So, I mean, yo, Korea definitely drank that Babylon juice, all right? See, man, a lot of it doesn't make any sense, like him screaming at that girl's butt, you know, because, you know, Jake grows up in different cultures, so they think other stuff is cool, you know. You're not going to have every Jake into that black culture, you know. He's into that South Korean culture, you know. I'm going to grab the scriptures, though, all right? This is Romans 8 and 16, all right? The Spirit itself beareth witness with our spirit that we are the children of God. All right? you know that you know, 'cause what this dude reminded me was this other group. You know, they're a poppin' group in 2013 too. All right. They're the same, man. They're wearing those, you know, crotch chokers. They got that techno music upbeat, you know, shuffling, doing the little dances, man. That's the same, man. They're definitely that Korean, you know, he's definitely an Israelite, man. You know, even though he's sold out, because check this out, man. They both have given into that Babylonian juice, all right? And it's not working. Hold on. Why is it not working? It's like you. Yeah. This is Revelation 18 and 3. For all nations have drunk of her wine of the wrath of her fornication. All right. Now that wine of the wrath of her fornication is talking about the harlot that was on top of the beast, which is American philosophy, all right? You know, that Western philosophy has spread throughout the world, all right? And the kings of her earth have committed fornication with her, and the merchants of the earth have waxed rich through the abundance of her delicacies. So, you know, all the nations that have taken part of the Western philosophy has also made money off of America, you know, because South Korea was getting backed by America, all right? And our people are the ones that sell out with it, all right? Yeah, this is 1 Maccabees 1 and 11. In those days went there out of Israel wicked men, who persuaded many, saying, let us go and make a covenant with the heathen that are round about us. For since we departed from them, we have had much sorrow. You know, because when you try to keep the customs of the Hebrew Israelites in a strange land, you're going to be looked at as different, treated like shit. You know, just like the brothers out on the highways and byways, you know, all we're doing is telling our people that they're Israelites to stop being sluts and stop being gangsters and stop selling dope, stop smoking weed, you know, and repent because the kingdom is coming. And we catch a lot of hell for that, you know. So this device pleased them well. Then certain of the people were so forward herein that they went to the king who gave them license to do after the ordinances of the heathen, whereupon they built a place of exercise at Jerusalem according to the customs of the heathen. So they sold out, basically, and made themselves uncircumcised and forsook the holy covenant and joined themselves to the heathen and were sold to do mischief. So yeah, our people are gonna be into the customs and cultures of, you know, what whatever strange land that they're driven into, all right? But it's that spirit that bear witness that they're the spirit of that they're the children of God, all right? You know, they have that zeal, they have that salt, they have that flavor, right? You know, because Israelites are a peculiar people. All right. Exodus 19:5. Now, therefore, if ye will obey my voice indeed and keep my commandment and keep my covenant, then ye shall be a peculiar treasure unto me above all people, for all the earth is mine. Right now, this is mainly talking about the elect, right? Because really the elect are that holy, special people. You know, and really the elect are going to bear witness with our spirit. You know, it's not necessarily about, you know, who's the best dancer, entertainer, or whatever. Or who's the hardest worker. You know, it doesn't matter unless, you know, you're working for Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai. Because that's who he's really dealing with. I'm going to jump back to that Romans 8:16, you know. So I can read it again. Alright, Romans 8:16. The Spirit itself beareth witness with our spirit that we are the children of God. And if children, then heirs, heirs of God, and joint heirs with Mashiach. If so be that we suffer with him, that we may be also glorified together. You know, so really the only, you know, really this verse is talking about the elect, alright? Because only the elect are going to go out on the highways and byways and preach Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai. And that's a cut to you people commenting on the comment boards saying that I'm an Edomite or calling other confusion of faith brothers a heathen. Because you don't even go out. You don't even teach. You don't even prophesy in the name of Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai. You know? You just want to sit back behind the comment board, behind a username and scoff. You don't have any videos up. You know, you're not pushing you're not even pushing your own doctrine. You know? So I mean that means that you don't have the spirit, that your spirit isn't bearing witness with the elect, alright? You know, so you're being a two-third if you're sitting behind a comment board and scoffing. You know, because the elect are gonna be out on the highways and byways and preaching and pushing this word. Alright. Let's see. Another example of you know, Jake just being into various cultures. You know, because instead of just black culture, right? This is a Jake by the name of Darius Rucker, and he sings country music.
Introducing the new 100% fresh beef quarter pounder from McDonald's. For 100% sizzle, 100% juiciness, and 100% flavor. The new, hotter, juicier quarter pounder burgers. So good, they'll leave you 100% speechless.
Man, nobody wants your GMO shit. Hey, that's the spirit. You see what's on that TV? That's Duck Dynasty. You know, those are the, you know, redneck Jakes. You know, they had a reality TV show back back a while ago called, it was Duck Dynasty. And, you know, they made some money by selling duck calls. And they had a reality TV show. And you know, they started and ended every episode with a prayer. You know, and they showed that zeal. You know, I'm going to get that. Yeah, Romans 10 and 2. Well, I'll start at verse 1. Romans 10 and 1. Brethren, my heart's desire and prayer to Yahweh by Shemiah Shai for Israel is that they might be saved. All right, so only Israel is going to be saved. For I bear them record that they have a zeal of the Most High power, but not according to knowledge. All right? Because, you know, those Duck Dynasty people, you know, they caught some hell because they didn't want to push that homosexual vibration out. You know, they missed out on like a shit ton of money, and they're like, nope, this is where our morals are. You know, you can go screw yourself. They stopped their show. But yeah, you know, especially down here in the South. You know, they call the South the Bible Belt because, you know, you got a lot of so-called white people that go to church every Sunday. You know, you listen to country music, it's about blues. You know, it's about the blue-collar struggle. You know, working Monday through Friday, drinking beer on the weekends, and going to church on Sundays. You know, that's what country music is about. And you got country music musicians that's selling out too. You know, you got country songs. You know, I'm gonna get some in a second, but this is just to show you. This Jake is into country music.
Staring up the road and pray to God I see headlights. I made it down the coast in 17 hours, picking me a bouquet of dogs.
You know, because he grew up in the South, he was around that. But just to mention a country artist that sell out, Kane Brown. He has a new song, yeah, Heaven. Man. Mother worship. And this dude is a confusion of faith too, because his mom's white and his dad is black, you know? Listen to the lyrics. This is a sold out song. Giving into the women worship.
This is perfect. Come kiss me one more time. I couldn't dream this up, even if I tried. You and me in this moment feels like magic, don't it? I'm right where I wanna be. Everybody's talking about heaven like they just can't wait to go. Saying how it's gonna be so good, so beautiful. Lying next to you, in this bed with you, I ain't convinced. Cause I don't know how, I don't know how heaven could be better than this.
Man, if that ain't some sold out shit, man. He's talking about how he'd rather stay and be with his woman forever and ever instead of being in the kingdom. When in the kingdom, you can have any chick you want. You know, you're gonna have everything that your heart desires. You know, that's in the scriptures too. You know, King David. King David, when he slept with that dude's wife, you know, the Lord kind of got pissed off at him. He's like, you're the king. You could have had more women if that's what you wanted. I'm going to try to find it real quick. All right, yeah, it's in 2 Samuel 12 and 8. And I gave thee thy master's house and thy master's wives into thy bosom, and gave thee the house of Israel and of Judah. And if that had been too little, I would moreover have given unto thee such and such things. So he's pissed off that he slept with another man's wife, but he wasn't mad that he had multiple wives. In fact, he said, if you wanted more, if that wasn't enough for you, I would have given you more wives, you know? But you got Jake selling out to these in these contracts to these record deals, and they're saying you know, you got to make a song about you know, giving it woman worship, you know, because that's not the only country singer that gives into that woman worship vibration. You got Keith Urban. And why is it not doing right? Keith Urban has a song called Female. You know, it's a hit single, you know? He's not known for making singles, man. But when it's about woman worship, it goes top to the top charts. Number one hit. Alright? You just listen to these lyrics, you can tell that it's definitely sold out.
Popping candy in the cream to give it a sweet, fizzy sensation. Try all three flavors.
How to see somebody hits like a girl? How does that hit you? Is that such a bad thing? When you hear a song that they play saying you run the world,
secret keeper, hell nah. Females are the worst secret keepers, man. Virgin Mary, there it is. Fortune teller, Virgin Mary. Man, Keith Urban sold out too, man. You know, it's not just through black culture that they're, you know, and if you listen to country music that comes on today's radio stations, you know, that new country, you know, all it is, like, it's getting less away from being, like, a country boy can't survive, or Johnny Cash, God's gonna cut you down. It's getting less gospel-y and less rough country, and it's getting more pop culture-y, you know, talking about parties, talking about women worship, things of that nature, you know. Yeah, man, those are some examples. You know, with that, I hope this video is edifying to the elect and one-third out there. Barak Tom and Shalom.